Hello guys, welcome back to Tech Dose, and in this video we will see the sublist search. That means given two lists, one a text list and another a pattern list, we want to determine whether the pattern list is a sublist of the text list. It can also be in the form of a string. Both these problems will be the same. So let us see the brute force method and then we will apply the efficient algorithm. So in the brute force method, you will have two pointers. Let us say this is pointer I and let us say this is pointer j. And what you will do is you will compare the first element of both the text and pattern. If they matches, then we will move both the text as well as the pattern. Okay, now B is also matching, so we will move on to X and this will be C. Now C and X are not matching. Now in the brute force method, what we will do is we will just cancel this out and we will just reset this pointer I to the starting position and we will reset this j to the next location from where we had started searching in the previous search. So previously we had started from this A, so now we will start from B. Now this B is not matching with A, so we will update this j to X. This X is also not matching with A, so we will update this to A. Now this A is matching with A and then we will update both I as well as j. Now this B is matching with B, we will update both I as well as J. This C is matching with C, so we will update them both. Okay, and now the elements have finished in the pattern and so we can say that this pattern is present in the given text. And the time complexity for this algorithm, as you can easily guess, that it will be order of M into M, where M is the length of the text, this M is the length of text, and this n will be the length of pattern. So this will be a multiplication of both of them, order of m into n. Let us look at the efficient algorithm. Let us convert the given list in the form of a string. So this is a text and this is our pattern. Now let us look at the intuition behind this efficient method. What we actually want to do is we want to find this pattern, whether this pattern is actually present in this given text or not. What we were doing is we were taking each of the elements one by one. We were comparing this A with A. Both these were matching. So we were updating the pointers. We were comparing B and then again we were comparing C with X. Now C and X is not matching. So what we were doing is we were resetting this pointer to the starting location. This was our I pointer. And in this case, we were just cancelling out all this and we were putting the J pointer to the next position of the previous search start position. So in the previous search we had started from this A, so now we will be putting this pointer to B and again we will start from this location. So this was taking a lot of time. So in the efficient method, what we will be doing is we will not be moving back in the text, we will only be moving back in the pattern. Okay. So let us say that we have started from this A, this I from A, and this we have also started from A. Now this A and A are matching, so we will update this to B and we will also update this to B. B and B are matching, we will update them both. Okay, now X and C are not matching. What we will do is we will now keep moving to the left, we will keep moving to the left until we find X. And if all the elements ends, then this pointer will be set to the first element. We can see that to the left of C, there is no X. So B will be compared, B is not X, A is not X. So this pointer will be set to A. Okay, since this is the first element. Now A and X are compared and they are not equal. So we will update this to A. Now this A is compared with A, they matches. So both of them will be updated. B will be compared with B, they matches, so both of them will be updated. C is compared with C, they again matches, both of them will be updated. A matches with A and similarly B matches with B. Now what happens is this text is pointing to C and in the pattern J is pointing, in the pattern I is pointing to this Y. Now C and Y are not equal. So what we will do is we will keep moving to the left until we find a C, and if we don't find a C, Then we will start from the starting location. We will keep moving to the left and we find a C. You can see that C is present at the third location. So what we will do is we will move this to A and this one also to A because we have found C. And now this A will be compared with this A and then this will be updated and again it is B. B will be updated and again it is Y. And so you can see that ABC ABY has been found. Okay, so what is the intuition behind this algorithm? Why are we stopping at finding C? We are actually determining the longest prefix. We are determining the longest prefix which is equals to the longest suffix. Okay, so in this case, when we were at this C and we were at this Y, let me write it in a separate line, ABX, ABC, ABC, ABY, and we had the pattern as ABC, ABY, and let me change the color. When we were starting from this, okay, then what we were doing is ABC, AB had matched, so we were matched till this fifth location, and now when we were at C, then this was not matched with Y. Now why are we stopping at this C? We are stopping at this C because we already know that the elements which has already been compared, you can see that this AB within this entire text, the longest prefix which is also a suffix is AB because AB is the prefix here and this is the suffix. And you already know that this C was compared with this Y and this position can only be reached if this A and B have already matched. You already know that this A and B have matched and therefore you have reached C and this has reached, this I has reached J. This is I and this is J. This I has reached Y and this J has reached C. This can only happen if this A and B have already matched. So you know that these have matched and if this is also equal to the prefix of this given pattern, then you don't need to match it again. Okay. So what we are doing is we are finding the longest prefix which is also the suffix, because if you try to match these prefixes then it will just be a overhead and a waste of time. So we will not match this and we will start just from C. Okay, so now let us look at the entire algorithm and see how it works. So this is the given text and this one is the given pattern. What we will do is we will have to form an array which is also known as the LPS array, just like in KMP algorithm, from this pattern. So you have the pattern as ABC and ABY, and what we will do is we will form an LPS array. It is called LPS 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. Now you will have two pointers, an I pointer and a J pointer. So let us say this is I and let us say we start J from above. We will match this. The first element will be 0 and this 0 denotes the length of the longest suffix which is also the prefix. We assume that if you have just one character in a string, then the longest prefix which is also equals to suffix will be 0. We are just assuming it. Okay, we will start J from this index 1. Now A and B will be matched. They are not matching, so the longest suffix which is also a prefix length will be 0. Now we will move J. When we are considering this ABC, then you can see that all the elements are unique. So there will be no suffix which will be equals to prefix. So the length of the longest suffix which is equals to prefix will be 0. Now we will move and include this A. You can see that A and A both are matching. So what will be the length of longest suffix which will also be a prefix? If we write the string ABCA, then the longest suffix which will also be a prefix is length 1, because this A is a prefix and this right one is a suffix and they both are equal. And this can be of longest length 1 only in this case. So here we will write 1. And how we calculate this 1? We actually this A is matched with A. So this index of A plus 1, we will write index of this A plus 1. So 0 plus 1 will be 1. Now since these have matched, so we will update this I and we will update this j as well. Now this b has matched with b, so what will be the length of longest suffix, which is also a prefix? The string will be abcab. Here you can see that ab is a prefix and ab is also a suffix, and this is the longest prefix ab, which is equals to the longest suffix ab. So the length is 2. And from this array, how we can calculate it? I is pointing to this b, which has matched with the index 4. So index 1 plus 1. Okay. And now we will move to y, and this will also be updated. This y is not matched with this c. So we will have to move back and we will look at the value at this previous index. So the value stored is 0, we will move to index 0. So at index 0 we have a, and a will be compared with y. They are not equal, therefore we will write 0. Because if you consider the string a b c a b y, there is no suffix which is equals to prefix. So there will be no longest suffix which will be equals to the longest prefix. Therefore it will be 0. Now let us repeat the process in order to understand it better. Okay, so let me calculate it by just using the two pointers. I have taken too long in order to calculate it. Let me do it by using two pointers. We have assumed this 0 for the first location. A and B are not matching, therefore I will write here 0. I will update J. When they are not matching, then only we will update J. And if they are matching, then we will have to update both I and J. C is not matching with A, therefore I will write 0. Now, A is matching with A. Therefore, what we will do is, I will write the index of this A plus 1. This is index 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, 4 and 5. So this will be 0 plus 1, therefore it will be 1. I will update both of them because they had matched. Now B is matching with B. Therefore, the value here will be index of this B, which is I, plus 1, which will be 1 plus 1. It will be 2. We will update both I as well as J. Now this C is not matching with Y. So what we will do is, in the previous location of this C, which is index 1, what is the value? We have value 0. So we will move to location 0. At location 0, we have character A. Now A will be matched with Y and they are not matching. And since this is the first element, so there will be no element to the left of A to be compared. And therefore, there will be no longest prefix which will be equals to suffix. Therefore, we will write here 0. Now, in order to do this pattern search, we will require this array. So let me draw this array clearly. Okay. So this is our array 0, 0, 0, 1, 2 and 0. Okay. This is very similar to the KMP algorithm. This is A, B, C, A, B and Y. We will have indices as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Let us now see how can we compare it with the text. So let us say this text is pointed by I and this A is pointed by J. Now this A and A both are matching, so we will update this I and we will also update the J. B is also matching, we will update it to X, we will update it to C. Now X and C are not matching. So what I will do is, I will move to the previous location and look at the value. So the previous location of C is having B and the value is 0. So I will move to index 0. At index 0 we have A. A will be compared with X and it is not equal. And since A is the first element, we will not do anything, but we will just update this text. Okay, we will update this I pointer. Now we have the pointer at this A. A will be compared with A. Okay, and they both are equal, therefore it will be incremented and this I will also be incremented. Similarly, B equals B, so this will be incremented to C, this will be incremented to C. Now C is equals to C, therefore I will be incremented, J will also be incremented. Similarly for A as well as for B, they both will be incremented. Okay, and now we have reached this point C. In the text we have reached C and in the pattern we have reached Y. Now C will be compared with Y. They are not equal. Now at what location should we look? We will look at the value stored at the previous location. So the previous location is Y is having B and the value is 2. So we will look at index 2. At index 2 we have C. Now C will be compared with this C. Okay, this all will be cancelled and we will be present at location C. Now C is compared with C and they both are equal. Okay, and why are we not moving to the starting location? Because this A, B and this AB are equal. Okay, so this is the longest prefix. This AB is the longest suffix which is equals to the prefix. And since this AB has already been matched, therefore we don't need to compare it again. Now C is matched with C. Again, we will move to A and this will also be updated. This A matches, therefore we move to B. This B also matches, we move to Y. And this Y now matches. Therefore, we have found our pattern to be ABC ABY present in the text. Okay, so the pattern is present. And what is the time complexity of this algorithm? The time complexity of this algorithm will be order of M plus N, where M is the length of this text and N is the length of this pattern. It may seem like the time complexity is more than order of M plus N, but you can see that once we have moved ahead in our text, we are not coming back. And since we are using this LPS array, this temporary array, in order to find out the longest prefix which is also equals to suffix, we have already calculated it, so it won't take much time in order to move back. We are not moving linearly, okay, we are not moving linearly. We are not doing any type of linear search, but we are using this array, the calculated array, in order to just jump to the correct location. We are just making a small number of jumps. But the trade-off is that the space complexity will be order of n, where n is the size of the pattern. So if we take some extra space, then we can reduce time from order of mn to order of m plus n. So this is a great achievement. So this algorithm, as you can see, is very similar to the KMP algorithm, which is used to find whether a pattern is present in a text or not. But here in the sublist search, we were given two lists. So what we were doing is, when we are given these two lists, we are converting it into two strings. And then after converting it into strings, we can apply the KMP algorithm in order to find whether the given pattern is present in a text or not very efficiently. So this is it for this lecture. I hope you were able to understand. If you have any type of doubt, then do comment below and I will try to help you as soon as possible. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of these programming videos. See you in our next video. Thank you.